I am appealing to you, Mr. President. Please, listen to these people. Mr. President, sana ibalik mo ang buhay nito mga tao na ito to normal. Not only to the QGC members, but also to you policemen. Galing pa ito sa ibang region na ilang araw na dito, walang matinong higaan, walang matinong kain, walang matinong tulog, walang matinong ligo. I am appealing to you, Mr. President. Please act on this. Huwag ninyo isara yung utak ninyo para mahuli lang si Pastor Kibuloy. You are willing to sacrifice everything. That's only an appeal. I hope you are listening. So again, I'm throwing back to you the question. How long do you intend to stay there? I think before we suspend this hearing. Ano ba talaga? Are you willing to sacrifice the future of the children, ng mga estudyante? Hindi sila makapag-aral dahil sa continued crisis niyo dyan sa area?
Sir, we are not preventing them.
Huh?
We are not preventing them to continue with their...
Yeah, you are not preventing them, but ako ang estudyante. Hindi ako mapasok dyan na ganyan kadaming pulis. Hindi ako papasok dyan. Ako teacher, hindi ako komportable na magkaklase dyan kung ganyan kadaming pulis sa loob.
I think more than me, sir, there's one person that we can ask to end all of this, sir. And I think we know who he is. Because
kaya nga, your quest for the arrest of Pastor Kibuloy would mean sacrificing everything. Yung mga bata na nag-aaral, yung mga tao na nakatira dyan, ganun ba? So you will continue to stay. Hindi ba pwedeng bigyan nyo muna ng relief yung mga tao dyan to back to their normal lives? Tapos kung meron na naman kayong positive info, go ahead. Go ahead. You arrest Pastor Kibuloy kung nandiyan siya sa loob. Alam mo, Nick, the way I see it right now, however you defend your position, you are at the losing end. Nakikita ko. And I think, I am suggesting to you, kung talagang after 13 days of occupation of that compound, still, hindi nyo na-aresto si Pastor Kibuloy, I think, it's high time for you to make a tactical retreat. For the meantime, huwag niyong gawin na rason na pasubo na kami dito. Tuloy-tuloyan na namin ito, sir, dahil napasubo na kami. You're not saying that, but ako, pakiramdam ko, yan ang nangyari ngayon. Napasubo na kayo dyan kahit hindi niyo nakikita. Pastor Kibuloy, tuluyan na lang ninyo. Ayaw na niyo umalis. Alam mo, kung babalik sa normal yung buhay ng mga taga-QGC, pag umalis kayo dyan, pati mga pulis natin, babalik rin sa normal yung buhay nila. And we are not preventing you from striking back. Kung meron kayong mabigat na informasyon na nandyan talaga si Pastor, pasukin nyo, arrestuhin nyo. Pero continuously staying there is detrimental to both of the parties, QGC at saka kayo, police. Detrimental to both sides yan. I am appealing to you in the name of humanity. Please be human enough to consider all these things. Please be human enough. I cannot give you a direct order Although gustong-gusto ko talaga sabihan kayo na umalis na kayo dyan, but I cannot give you a direct order, otherwise it will be a legislative overreach. I am not, I do, I, I'm not part of your chain of command. Hindi ko kayo pwede orderan dyan. But as part of our oversight function over you, we have all the reason in this world to give you our advice, our recommendation, how to do things properly in the name of humanity. Magiging normal ang buhay nila, magiging normal ang buhay ninyo, bumabalik kayo. Then kung meron na magiging informasyon, go ahead. Nobody's stopping you. Pero yung ganyan tuloy-tuloy na lang kayo, I am running out of reasons to explain to the people why of these policemen are still there after how many days continuously occupying because gusto nila kakalin lahat ng lugar. Hindi ko ini-invalidate yung mga rason ninyo na meron kayo nakikita, meron kayo informasyon, okay, that's part of your job. Pero sa ngayon naman siguro, you cannot justify your existence there inside the compound for how many days na. I know you're pressured by your commanders to arrest Pastor Kibuloy. They will not give you 3,000 people from other police regional offices. They will not support you with that gargantuan number of troops just to arrest one wanted person kung walang imprimatur yung galing sa us. Dami pressure kayo. But because of that pressure, napapasubok na kayo, nahiya na kayong umatras. I am giving you the advice. As early as now, you can make your tactical retreat, however you turn that, strategic retreat, you can do that. Pero kung sabihin mo sa akin, General Ture, that you will still continue to stay there, I don't know how to explain your continuous stay in that area armed with the warrant of arrest. After 13 days, hindi pa nyo nahuli yung hinahanap ninyo. I am running out of reasons. I am running out of justifications. I want to help you. I want to help you justify your actions. Yung mga tao ko kayo dati. I'm trying to help you. I am trying to justify your actions, but I'm running out of justifications. Ngayon sabihin mo, tuloy-tuloy niyo pa. Well, I don't know how to deal with this situation. Kung nakikinig sana si President Bongbong Marcos ngayon, I am appealing to you, Mr. President, please. Listen to these people, Mr. President. Sana ibalik mo ang buhay nito mga tao na ito to normal, not only to the QGC members, but also to your policemen. Galing pa ito sa ibang region na ilang araw na dito, walang matinong higaan, walang matinong kain, walang matinong tulog, walang matinong ligo. I am appealing to you, Mr. President. Please act on this. Huwag ninyo isara yung utak ninyo para huli lang si Pastor Kibuloy. You are willing to sacrifice everything. That's only an appeal. I hope you are listening. So again, I'm throwing back to you the question. How long do you intend to stay there?
Sir, same with the commitment earlier, we won't stop until we arrest Polo Tugulong, sir. We believe he is in KOJC compound and we'll look for him. If only the KOJC members will cooperate with us, leave us alone what we are doing, we're not hurting them. We're not hurting them. They are the ones impeding us. We want to go into a building, why impede us? Stay away. It's not you that we're targeting. We are looking for Apollo Quiboloy, Crescente Canada, Ingrid Canada, Silvio Simanez, and Roy. What's the first name, Roy? Jacqueline Roy. Those are the people that we're interested in. We're not interested in Dr. Badoy. We're not interested in Marlon Acobo. We're not interested in Panat Bay. We're not interested in anybody except for the pie. Let us look for them freely.